I'm gonna insert that into my, vagina. But a lot of you are saying that, things that you receive inside your vagina that are way bigger than, like, they are like times five or times six of this, and you put them inside you. But anyway. Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Thank you so very much for joining me today. If it is your first time, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Funke Oshin. Turn on your notification bell. Click on the notification bell right beside the word subscribe. That is for you to get my videos, to be the first to always get my video anytime I post. Thank you so much for your support so far. So today, guys, I'm here to come and make some contracts to make my review between tampon and pads. You know, guys may want to say this video is not for me, but then I'm sure you have sisters, I'm sure you have girlfriends, and I'm sure that you want them to always be comfortable when it comes to that time of the month. So I don't mind you staying back and watching this video while it lasts. But for my ladies, majorly this is for you. That I'm gonna be talking about tampons and then pads. It's so funny that majority of Nigerian ladies don't know what tampon is. Okay, I'm 26 and I got to the age 26 before I started using tampon, and before I knew what exactly tampon is. You know, I'm always reading it online, I'm always seeing it online, I'm always like, what the hell is this? But the thing is, we always get orientation with pad. And anytime I'm hearing about this menstruation sensitization, when people are talking to people or orientation about menstruation in Nigeria, they're always talking about pads and they're always forgetting about tampons. But then I've eventually used both. And anything I'm going to be saying today is not to change your mindset or whatever. They are basically my opinion. This is not a sponsored post, so I'm not here to come sell a particular product, but I'm here to tell you my own preference. Okay, so today I'm going to be starting with pads because that's what we are more conversant with. I don't know if there are ladies who don't know pads. I'm sure when I was in school, I had a roommate then. That was university that was using clothes at this age. For our periods, first of all, that is not healthy. If you're a lady out there and you're still using clothes for your period or tissues, come on, these things, I know they are expensive. Pad has gone way there, but I know there are cheaper ones that are healthy that you can use, and if you don't have much money, but please stop using clothes. You may want to say that is what women were using back then. But that was then. There are a lot of things you eat now. There are a lot of places you go to now that you can attract diseases from. So please don't use clothes. Try to use pads. So this is the way pads looks like. This place is where you put on your panties. This is where you place on your panties, and then there's something like this. I don't want to waste this pad, but so I'm just going to be careful with it. There's a closure here. You're going to open this. You just slit this open. You slit this open. And then you open the wings, the middle of your panties, you cover this here, and then there you go. Okay, and there's something about pads that we ladies don't really like, and that is the noise that pad makes. Me personally, I have heavy flow. I'm always having heavy flow, and I use two pads at once. When I'm saying at once, I wear two pads together. That's when I use pad. I place one on my panties, wear it, and then I wear another pant with another pad attached to it, and I wear two pants and two pads together. That's for you to know how serious it always is when I'm in my period. It's always, and even at that, I still get stained. So when you're using pad, you get some uneasy feeling. You get to feel the fact that yes, I'm wearing pad. There's something in there. There's something heavy in there. And when it falls, when there's clotting, when that clotting, that thick dark blood comes out, you feel this, you're like, oh my god. You can't, when you sneeze, you feel the fact that the blood is gushing out. When you cough, you feel the blood gushing out. It's always crazy, guys. Very, very crazy. And the fact that when you're walking, sometimes you get to hear the fing, 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 fing sound of some products of pads. It's just crazy. And then I can remember when I was in school, in uni, I was going to class, then a friend of mine just saw me, said, Funke, are you in your period? I was like, am I stained? She was like, no, but I can see the shape of your pad. I was like, wow. I was in the hostel before I went to class, so I quickly ran back to go change and wear something that my pad is not going to be showing in the clothes. So that's part of the things, the pros and cons for pads. You get uncomfortable, you keep checking yourself, please let me check, am I stained? It's just crazy. And I remember when I was during my NYSC when I was on camp, I actually got stained. It was even during Saeed. If you've gone for NYC camp before, or if you're still serving, you can know how crazy that could be. You know, we are wearing white fowl, white shorts, white shirts, and then during Saeed, during all those boring lectures where a lot of people are, and I was in OBS, and we have seats in front, and I got up, and I was stained. Oh my God. I think few people saw me anyway. I was quickly able to, you know, use my khaki jacket and all that, and I ran to the hostel. So these are the things that you go through when you're using pad. You're always scared of being stained. You can't wear white when you want to. You can't, you keep feeling that heaviness, and the whole day just seems funny to you, and you feel like, oh Lord, can this period just pass? So that's just about pads. I know a lot of people know a lot about pads, so I'm here to talk. I'm going to be talking more on tampons and the benefits of tampons, the disadvantages and the advantages, and the pros and cons. So this is how tampon looks like. People always tend to say that I'm gonna insert that into my, you know, vagina. But a lot of you are saying that, you know, things that you receive inside your vagina that are way bigger than it, like they are like times five or times six of this, and you put them inside you. But anyway, okay, so this is how tampon looks like. It's always going to be strange anytime I see it for the first time. The first time I used it, I think I started it well, but I felt I didn't put it very well inside. But I don't know, it just felt awkward anyway. I kind of felt like, hey, there's something inside me. But the thing is, first of all, you have to relax whenever you want to use the tampon. Relax your mind, relax your body. Just put it in there, just insert it in there. And this is how to use a tampon. You push this inside. After wearing, make sure that your hands are clean before you use your tampon, and then just relax yourself and just push this in like this. So it's gonna be like this, it's gonna come out like this. Push it in like this. All these things, this is going inside you, and once you are here, you just remove this, and there you go. Make sure that this string stays outside. So this place to this place is what stays inside you. Here, this is what stays inside you. Make sure that this string is left outside, so that when you're done, when you have to change, you just pull this string, bam, and you flush out your tampon. You don't, if this goes in, there's no way you're gonna bring it out again. One thing I would say that makes pad more usable is that pad doesn't require a lot of instruction or precautions. Just use it the way you use it all the time. Just put it on your panties and just keep going. But for tampon, you have to be very careful. You can use pad for like 8 hours, but you can't use tampon for that long. You can't use tampon for 8 hours. You're gonna get TSS, and that is toxic shock syndrome. It's something, if you want to use pad, tampons rather, the highest you can go is maybe 7 hours. 7 hours is even too much. Max is 6 hours. But then when you put tampon inside, you don't feel absolutely anything. You can go swimming with your tampons. You can have your shower with your tampons still inside you. There's no inconvenience or uncomfortability that, hey, am I stained? Only if you use it for too long. And there are different types. There's regular, there's super plus. Me, I already told you that I have, I'm always having heavy flow. I use the super plus, and then I don't change until like 6 hours, and I still feel very good. Just in case it stays longer than it's supposed to, and if there's gonna be a little leakage. So I use panty liner all the time when I use tampon. The tampon is in there, and just this little panty liner is on my panties just to support me, so in case there's any little leakage when it stays too long in there. But seriously, I use tampon and just wear my panties sometimes. But then I've never experienced the inconvenience since I started using tampon this year. In I think January or February. Being in my period has just been easy going for me. I don't tend to always say, am I stained? I don't tend to always say, I don't use to double pass like I used to. You don't use tampon at night. Yes, it's very easy to use, but don't use that night because you tend to sleep, oversleep. And sometimes if I use at night, I make sure that I set my alarm to particular, maybe 5 hours so that I can wake up and change. If you leave it there, I've experienced this toxic shock syndrome before. I've experienced it before, and in the midnight I just woke up and I started feeling shaking some kind of way, and I quickly had to go remove the tampon and then use pad. So now it's not like I've forgotten pad totally. every month I buy my tampon and I buy my pad, but I use my tampon more often. At night I change to pads and I use my pads. So but tampon is easy going. You don't feel, people say it feels like there's something inside me, but it's a lie. For tampon, you have to be careful, you have to be time conscious, you have to check the time always, you have to know that yes, it's time to change. Max is 6 hours. Some people will tell you 7-8 hours, you can use it for 8 hours, but no, max is 6 hours. I don't use it for more than 6 hours and I change, and it's not expensive. Some people that even know about tampons in Nigeria, they will tell you that I'm not using it because it's expensive. No, tampons are not expensive, they are affordable. Use them, and I use them since I started using them, guys. Being on my period has not been a burden again. It's so serious, apart from the fact that maybe I have cramps once in a while, but I don't get uncomfortable. I wear white if I want to whenever I'm in my period without me being scared of being stained. I wear tight clothes without me thinking that my pad line is showing. I've showered before with my tampon in when I came back from work, and I felt like, okay, I changed my tampon 2 hours ago, so I don't have to change again now. So I just had my shower and my tampon was still inside me. So it seems it's very comfortable. Just make sure that the string is out there and you pull it out and then you change. Your first time is gonna be, you know, strange. It's gonna be funny to you. And another thing is, recently a friend of mine that made me to know this tampon, she came over to my place some times ago and she slept over, and she just something else. She did another stuff in my presence. I was like, oh wow, this is a good style, and I've been trying it since then. Yes, she's going to watch this now. She's going to feel like a pro because she made me to know how, what tampon is. She made me to start using tampon, and now she taught me. She didn't per se taught me, because teach me rather, because I didn't tell her I was going to adopt the style, but then she's now going to be feeling like a pro when she sees this video. Okay guys, this is going to be awkward, but then just watch this. Your legs will be up like this, and then you put. So the only time I squat to put it in is maybe I'm in the public toilet, I'm outside, I'm not home. But anytime I have to use it at home, I just rest on my bed and just put it in, and it enters so easily. Now some people want to say that maybe tampons are not for virgins, but guys, seriously, this is 2019. I can't believe that some people are still thinking that the breaking of hymen is what virginity is. No, a lot of people have broken their hymens from not having sex at all. Some people, dancers, I've seen some dancers who have their hymen broken while dancing. I've seen ladies, athletes who have their hymen broken while dancing without even having sex at all. So if you are still having that mindset that your hymen being intact is what shows that you're a virgin in this 2019, and if you are a millennial, if you're not a young girl like a teenager and you're still having that thought, I wonder what I'm sorry. If you are saying that the tampon is going to break your hymen, so you don't want to use it, my sister. Anyway, it is your decision to make. But then, isn't it better to have comfortability? Would you rather use tampon? Would you rather use pad? My advice today, whatever I say today again, are my opinions. But then, I love tampon. I'm now a tampon person. I don't do any month period without using tampon again. I use tampon, and I just support with pads at night. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching today. Thank you. Nigerians, we need to, you know, increase our mentality about these things and just be comfortable. We don't want to be messy around. Thank you so much, guys. If you enjoyed this video, make sure that you like it, subscribe to my YouTube channel, please. I can't help but to keep asking you guys to subscribe, so please subscribe to my channel. Drop your comments down below, let me know which one you prefer, let me know which one you're always using. Is it pads or is it tampons? Thank you so much for watching. Like this video, turn on notification if you haven't done that yet. And I promise you guys that more contents are going to be coming on here. Just keep watching, keep your fingers crossed, and keep supporting. I love you guys.